So playing with a racing seat is really fun, but you know what's not fun is actually paying for one. Because base price, a racing seat like this, especially one that holds a monitor, they start around $600, and I think we could do a lot better. So let me show you how. As far as 3D printed parts goes, there's only four different models used inside of this design. You've got what I call the elbow, and of course you can just get a 90 degree connector for PVC, and that would cover you for this. You don't need to 3D print this, but I just like how convenient it is to the model I like. The next one is, I call it the dog bone. And really all it is the gives it the ability to connect one pipe to another pipe, and then that pipe goes across. Now the difference between this 3D printed part and the part that you would buy, a T connector, is there's going to be, at the one that you buy in the store, it's basically gonna have a ring in the middle, and it's gonna keep the pipe from sliding back and forth. The ability for the pipe to slide back and forth inside this connector helps tremendously when you're putting it together, and it gives it a lot more strength because the pipe is continuous across the model. So could you do this with a regular T connector? You could, but what you would need to do is you're going to need to drill out that connection in the middle so that the pipe can slide freely inside the T-bone. The next model is simply an end cap, and I designed this end cap for a specific reason. What I did was, the end cap goes into the pipe, and then once you screw in the screw hole on the top, it expands so it locks into the pipe. But once again, you could just get an end cap and put it on the ends of the pipe where this model is inside the larger project, and you would really have no problem. The real point is the ability to put a platform or whatever on top of the pipe, and then the pipe supports the weight of the project, and then you screw down into the end cap. So a regular end cap would still work in this case. So, and once again, not a part that you have to 3D print. All right, last but not least is what I call the cube corner, because it's really a corner piece in a cube model. And I actually have one printing out right now, but here's another example. Here's just a picture of the model out of Fusion 360. The point of the cube corner is the fact that the pipe on the outside can support weight. So it's not the connector itself that's supporting the weight, it is the pipe itself. So that's clutch when you build the platform for the seat and for the monitor stand. So that's why this piece is somewhat critical, but you can still build it, but you're going to have to find a three-prong 90-degree connector, which is not necessarily easy when it comes to PVC pipe. Now, having said that, you can still do it, and there's websites out there that sell like construction pieces for PVC pipe, but they're simply not as convenient, and I like the ability for the pipe to be able to slide through that corner piece, and it helps it support weight, and it makes it a lot easier to use. But once again, it's not completely critical to the project, and you could do a simple workaround, especially if you use the T-bones in its place. You're really not going to have a problem, but just something to think about. Okay, so let's check out the model itself. The base down here right now is 4.5 feet, so I used 5-foot sections from Lowe's of PVC pipe, but you can actually buy PVC pipe in 10-foot sections. It makes it a lot cheaper. Now, the seat obviously is a JEG seat and cost me only about $36 off of Amazon, so that was super cheap. And then four pieces of plywood, or four plywood pieces. I only used two plywood pieces that I bought at Lowe's, and believe it or not, the most expensive part of this whole project was the stupid plywood. And I don't know if there's a plywood shortage or what's going on right now, but plywood was a little bit more expensive than I thought. This section is basically one piece, 24 by 24, and then I cut these pieces out of another 24 by 24, and then these two came from another 24 by 24. So you have to really buy either three pieces, obviously, of 24 by 24, or you can get one and a half of 24 by 48. So it's totally up to you. Now, this is one of the biggest things I wanted to explain of why this design is so forgiving is that when you use the connectors and you dry fit this project together, it is very forgiving because as long as these pieces here are the same length, that gives you a square. As long as this piece and this piece is the same length, then that squares up the entire base. So no issues there. And obviously, as long as these legs are the same height, which they don't even have to be, that way you could get more of a tilt on your base for your seat. That's totally up to you. And we'll go into that in a later video, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to dramatically shorten this back piece. And what that's going to do is give me that F1 racer type layout. Now, what's cool about down here is these two pieces, if you need to raise or lower per your preference the pedal platform, all you have to do is cut these pieces a different length. If you add to them, this platform gets higher. If you subtract, obviously it gets lower. These are 90 degree angles, so no significant issues here. You could use regular elbows. Now what happens is in the model, these twist outwards and give you a kind of a cool looking angle out, but it's very forgiving because what you're going to do is you're going to make sure that this piece and this piece are the same height, depending on how high you want your monitor stand. And when you do that, once you bring them together a little bit, then these crossbars will fit automatically. And then what I did is I screwed this piece into the crossbar, this piece into the crossbar. And then this piece slides up and down with the T-bones. So really simple, flexible, and very forgiving design. It looks really good as well. These pieces right here, depending on your type of steering wheel setup, you can cut these shorter or longer, and that'll give you a little bit different layout back and forth if you want to adjust forward or back. No problems there. Now, if you want this up or down, all you have to do is adjust the length of these pieces right here. And then basically that will give you the height that you need depending on how you want to do it. As well, you can just slide this bar up and down. The trick is to get everything where you want it before you start bolting it down, because once you do start bolting it down, the project gets a lot more difficult to adjust. So make sure everything fits and is where you like it before you start bolting stuff down. Next, I want to show you how your pieces and your components actually fit in here. Now, these are actually to scale. This is basically that Strix monitor. I think it's like 22 inches across, something like that. That's actually a model of that. This is the, I think it's a G21 Logitech, and it gives you a good example of there's plenty of space for these components to fit in here. Now, my steering wheel is a little bit different. It's a Thrustmaster, but no problem with fit for basically any steering wheel setup that you want. If you don't have enough clearance here, you can either push this cut back, or you can just adjust the monitor stand to go up just a little bit higher. Same thing down here. You can simply make these pipes a little bit shorter and cut them off a little bit of a shorter angle, and you're not going to have any issues there. Now, the way the platforms all secure to the model itself are really simple. There's end caps in these pipes, and simply bolt here, bolt here, bolt here, bolt here. Same thing with here. The bolts are across this crossbar, and then there's one bolt here and one over here. And then obviously the platform is super simple, just four bolts around the four corners, and then the bolts for the seat are in the middle. We'll be right back. as excited about this project as I am, it really is a lot easier than it looks. I'm going to put all of the builder's notes on in a link where you can get to them, no problem. I'll share them on my Google Drive or something, and you can get to that stuff. I'll put all the models on Thingiverse. They're easy to download and find. And I do plan on putting together some plans for this that will actually take you step by step by step through the whole process. I just haven't gotten to it yet. But if you're a little bit handy, and I don't mean super handy, if you're just even a little bit handy, you'll have no problem, because one of the coolest things about this model is I found as I started to go through and tweak the design a little bit, it's very forgiving. So as long as you dry fit all of the pieces before you go start bolting stuff down, you're not gonna have any issues, because you'll see where the PVC pipe is gonna flex a little bit, where it's not, where you can tweak it and where you can't. So it's really, really forgiving. So even if you're not super handy and not super perfect on your measurements and things, you're really still not gonna have a problem. So it's very adjustable. You can slide the seat back and forth before you bolt it down. You can move the monitor stand. You can use a larger height, a lower height. The same thing with the steering column. That crossbar can go up or down, and that gives you the ability to adjust where the steering column is as well. So extremely flexible model. I'm excited. I hope you enjoy it. Please let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.